Hey, this is Steve Tucker from Morbid Angel, and you're watching That Metal Interview Podcast.
Morbid Angel, a band from Florida, based from Florida, Tampa to be exact, formed in 83, give or take, by guitarist and founder and primary composer and sole remaining member, Trey Ezekthoff. But our guest for this episode of That Metal Interview is none other than the extraordinary Steve Tucker with his guttural vocals and awesome bass lines that complete the sound of Morbid Angel. Morbid Angel is considered to be one of the first bands to incorporate guttural vocals, blast beats, different tempo changes, and just the crazy atmosphere. No holds barred as far as formulas on the song, chorus, verse, intro, none of that. These guys, they do their own thing, and they're known for that. So just awesome metal for us metalheads. And anyways, let's cut it short. Let's enjoy our interview with Mr. Tucker. We'll be right back. Enjoy. Okay, so first of all, let's speak of Malefic Throne. Awesome self-titled EP. How did this come together? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, bro, that thing started off as really just kind of a joke between me and John Longstrength, man. And then next thing you know, we put together some songs. It was really, that shit was about COVID, bro. That was about everybody sitting at fucking home and not having anything to do, and you know what I mean? So, like, literally, that just spawned it, man. It started off as a little bit of a joke, and then we just wrote some songs together, man, it was fun, bro. I mean, it was really just about fun, and that's still what it's about, man, like, you know.
Did you guys send files to each other, or did you guys
jam? Dude, it was all done remotely. Every single moment of that was done remotely. You know, like, John did his stuff, you know, in New York somewhere. Gene did his stuff in, I think, Tampa. You know, I'm doing my stuff up in the mountains. You know?
Any plans to tour this project?
Oh, I don't really know right now, brother. I mean, like, dude, right now, you know, I'm in 100% Morbid Angel mode. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, that's, right now, that's 100% my focus, you know, because we're working. So, like, but, yeah, I mean, who knows, man? Who knows? Like I said, you know, sometimes you never know, bro. You never really know.
So you guys have preparations for the new tour right there, United States Tour of Terror. Are you excited?
Yeah, man, I'm real excited, bro. It's been over 3 years since we went out, and like, I'm ready to do it again. You know what I mean? It's been a long time. It seems like forever, to be honest.
Yeah.
So yeah, dude, I'm real happy to get back out, man, and play shows.
That's awesome for us fans. So you guys in rehearsals already, or are you guys?
Oh yeah, we're actually got one or two rehearsals left, and we leave, man. This tour is about to kick off, I believe, in a couple, 2-3 days, something like that. The 15th, I believe, is the first show.
Any surprises with songs or anything from every album, or are you just doing certain songs?
We're doing a couple songs from a wide range of the albums. There's going to be songs that probably people didn't expect, and I'm sure there'll probably be songs that people wanted to hear and don't get to this time around. That's sort of the thing when you've been around this long, is picking songs really kind of becomes about what's feeling good at the time. You know what I mean? So we started off with a bunch of songs, and then all the ones, you know, we decided on these 15 that, you know, feel the best. You know what I mean?
So who picks the songs? Is it Trey, or does everyone pitch in?
It's us in the room in the end. You know what I mean? I mean, Trey and I always talk about what songs we think we want to do, and then we start playing songs, and then, you know, we end up really, and then dropping some and picking other ones up and changing them, and it's just like a process, man. It's like a process of elimination, kind of.
Which is your favorite song to play live, Morbid Angel song?
Oh man,
too many.
There's so many cool. I mean, like, some of the stuff from Formulas, like when we do like Nothing Is Not. That's always, for me, it just feels awesome. And Summoning Redemption, man, always feels awesome. Why stand before thee? Conqueror, bless thee, come forth from sea. It's just so big, bro. You know, like, so, like, I mean, yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, I would have to pick songs from, you know, the albums that I was on. I mean, just because, I mean, those are songs that, you know, I was a part of, you know, so.
Yeah. So working with Trey, how is that? People know he's very private and not very social, I guess. How is that working with him?
I mean, Trey and I have known each other for, you know, I don't know, what, 25 years or more or something? So, I mean, honestly, for us, it's you know, we got used to it so long ago that for me, it doesn't, I don't know, working with Trey is just normal. It's just working with Trey, you know what I mean? Like, Trey is, you know, Trey's a highly motivated person. If people aren't really matching his energy, it's a bummer for him, you know what I mean? So, you know, I mean, I know what to expect though with Trey. So, you know what I mean? It for me, it's just a process that we do, you know what I mean? But I think for some people, if they were looking from the outside, they would think, wow, this guy's really intense. You know, this guy's really, you know, sort of maybe demanding, but bro, I think that's what's always set the guy apart.
Did you already know some of the bands, opening bands like Revocation, Crypto?
Oh yeah, we've toured with Revocation. Yeah, man, we, Charlie, the drummer on this tour, actually played in Skeletal Remains for a while. So yeah, man, we know most of these people. Never really met Crypta, you know. But you know, a week in the tour, we'll all be friends.
There's been some controversy about tour expenses and how bands are not making enough money on the road and all that. How do you see this in 2023 compared to other tours in the past?
I mean, I've got those same worries, man. You know, like, I mean, you know, fuck, everything costs double what it costs a few years ago.
Horrible.
You know what I mean? So literally, you know, the price of diesel, you know, for the vehicle to travel in from, to, you know, hotels on off days. I mean, just food, the daily food to eat, it all costs more. I mean, you know, t-shirts cost more. I hate that, man. I fucking hate that. You know what I mean? I hate what t-shirts have to cost in order for them to be doable. You know what I mean? Like, it's crazy, man. But dude, this is the world we live in, and I mean, you know, nobody let me make the rules, so it is what it is, you know.
So when can fans see the band in Mexico or South America or overseas?
I'm hoping next year, man. We're hoping next year.
2024. Very cool.
Yeah, we're hoping so. Yeah.
So how many basses do you carry on this tour?
I'm gonna bring out two of this tour. I'll bring out my custom SPV that Scott Pavernick built for me, man. It's my Tesla bass, my 369. I fucking love that bass, man. It fits me like no bass has ever fit me. And I'll also be playing a Legion bass as well. A buddy of mine has a company called Legion Guitars, and they're making some phenomenal guitars, man, and basses. And he sent me one to play to sort of give them my input on it. You know what I mean? And man, I ended up really, really, really liking this bass. So I'll be playing that quite a bit. It's a star body, pretty sick looking, 100% metal bass. You know?
Nice. Did you have to relearn lyrics for most of these songs, or did they come back naturally? Or
man, yeah, I think you know, it's one of those things where it's stuck in the RAM somewhere, and you just have to pull it back up. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
But yeah, I mean, you know, I've just listening to the songs a bunch, man. You know, I just listen to the songs a bunch, and you know, and kind of get you, it sets the mood for it, and then yeah, and then they sort of come back, man. But for me, man, I don't know and really understand fully how that works, but somewhere in me, man, there's some RAM, you know, and RAM is what's relevant, and it's everything that I haven't done in a long time still in there. All I have to do is just bring it out somehow, you know what I mean? And for me, like I said, listening to the songs multiple times, that seems to bring them back out, you know.
Wow, that's a lot of lyrics right there. Very cool.
Yeah, man, it is a lot of lyrics, actually, but it is what it is, man, you know.
Yeah, it's a job. So it's been 6 years since Kingdom's Disdained. Any new music coming in the works?
Yeah, I mean, I'm hoping so, man. I mean, we're tossing around some ideas and things like that. So, yeah, man, I mean, right now, man, we really are just trying to knock the fucking rust off, bro. Get back out, do shows, and get back used to being in a band. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there's a lot of social politics in a band. You know, you have multiple members, and you know, sometimes you have to get back in that vibe and in that groove, and get used to working together and around each other again. You know.
Changing gears here, any new music coming from Arise from Worms with Sonny?
Yeah.
I'll be doing another couple songs with him at some point, man. Like, Sonny's crazy, man. That guy writes some crazy ass shit.
Good stuff, yeah.
And, yeah, it's crazy, man. It's honestly, man, when you hear that stuff before the vocals and everything, you're like, holy shit, what is going on? But it all comes together in the end. It's fun, man. That's another one of those situations like the Malefic Throne, man. It was about, let's do something, man. Let's have some fun. You know what I mean? Let's make a few songs, man. You know, like, bro, I spent so many years being, you know, playing in one band. And don't get me wrong, man. Morbid Angel is my job.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Like, oh, yeah.
You know, but, like, but so many years you play with one band and you write one way. And it's always like, man, I wonder what it'd be like if I jammed with this guy because he's my friend and I really like him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And stuff like that. I decided at one point in my 40s, bro, I think it was during the Warfather record, I told Eric Rutan, you know, bro, I really want to start playing with people, just doing songs here and there, different stuff, different ideas, one-offs, man, just one song or whatever with people that I really like, and I like what they do, man, just to see what it would sound like, you know what I mean?
So speaking of Warfather, anything new there?
No, man, not at all at the moment, man. I do have there's plenty of music, and it's all sitting on the back burner, man, just, kind of really just right now just really didn't have the focus to go into that, you know. Warfather for me is like, I guess if you will, a solo thing. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And everyone involved is sort of like my choice, bro. You know what I mean? So if someone's involved, then it's because I wanted them to be, you know. And like, it's one of those things where members can change, but that's just because it just can happen. It's not because there was ever a problem or anything like that. It's just because, man, you know, like, just want to do something a little bit different, man. And right now, I just really don't have any need for that, bro. I did a few projects during the COVID that were fun to do, man. They were cool to do. They were a little bit different. And, like, it sort of filled up that area for me. You know what I mean? Like, I really just, I just don't have time to go into a process of writing a Warfather record at the moment.
Any other project you might want to mention?
Man, we already did a bunch of them.
Yeah.
Really, brother. I mean, not really. I'm just trying to stay busy and not go fucking crazy, man. You know, like, if you turn on the news, you think the world's fucking gone, lost its mind. You know what I mean? And I'm just literally trying to stay grounded, brother. Like, and for me, music's always been the way I stay grounded. So, you know what I mean? Some of these things I do, maybe nothing ever comes up with them ever again. But, bro, it kept me sane for an hour. I mean,
awesome, Steve. Thank you for your time. And would you like to send a message to your fans listening to this podcast?
Oh, man, I can't wait to have you guys standing in front of me again, man. That's my main focus in life right now is getting back on stage and having the fans in front of me and feeling that energy, man. You know, that's what I'm looking forward to.
Awesome, Steve. Thank you for your time. And we can't wait to see you guys in the road.
Have a great day, brother.
Absolute pleasure chatting with Mr. Tucker, and thank you for making some time during your rehearsals with the band in preparations for their upcoming tour or their current tour. It all depends when you're listening to this podcast. The United States Tour of Terror 2023, Morbid Angel headlining, of course. You got Revocation, Skeletal Remains, Crypta from Brazil, and Vitriol. So anyways, go out and check out these guys. Check out the tour dates on Morbid Angel's socials, official Morbid Angel on Instagram, and so on and so forth. Support Morbid Angel. Purchase their merchandise either on the road or through their social media websites. Check it out. And don't miss the other bands, of course. Awesome, awesome tour lineup. Big shout out to those people, too, those bands. Anyways, as far as our podcast, thank you for tuning in, downloading, streaming. Your friend James much appreciates your support. So anyways, until the next time, don't forget to keep it metal.
That metal interview.